Chapter 17. Naught but nightmares.
It's night.
The moon is so pretty!
So, are we really sure there's a key around here?
Well, I am getting some seriously intense Naught but Night vibes from the place.
I say we go to check out that town in the distance, the one with the light on.
Hey, is that, train? Guys, are we sure this thing's safe?
Looks like a one-way ticket to, you know.
You know I hate that kind of...
Your ticket.
It's just the conductor.
Oh, then this must be the same train as the always.
Huh? The conductor?
Yes, in all my succulentious glory.
What? Why did you scare me?
But, miss, you were practically begging for a good heart stopper. Ask and you shall receive, I say.
What kind of stupid, messed up logic is that? Stop doing that!
Zip, zip!
Would you cut that out?
Zip, zip, zip!
Just let me hit you!
Somebody zip! Zip! 50-odd years of cactuaring. I'd say I know a thing or two about dodging. Come and get me!
Get back here, you prickly pup!
sis? Rain, are you a...
Oh! Yeah, I've still got it.
Yeah, well, you don't have to give it to me!
You better keep practicing, little giant girl! Can't touch this cactuar!
One of these days, I'm gonna get you for this!
Okay, we're kind of getting off track.
That's for the sure.
Right, tickets, please! Go on, then. All aboard.
An anchor.
The Federation must have controlled this place.
Let's be careful.
Absolutely zero use for this.
Well, you never were too keen on the printed word.
I doubt anyone's gonna be burning through any paperbacks in this light.
The town is awfully dark. I mean, I know it's the land of Naught but Night, but it's still too early for the town to be sleeping, right?
Yeah, there should be more people around if you ask the me.
Hey, are you okay?
Huh?
What's the matter?
Huh?
What?
Run!
Ah!
Come on. Can you keep up?
Yes!
Yeah!
Yes, sir!
Oh, mirages we can handle!
Yeah, no sweat!
Okay, time to savage our reputation!
All right! Let's de-savage it!
You want him to think we're even more incompetent? Oh, whatever! Savage away!
See how you like this.
Your keepers? Right. The giants from the hills.
Ta-da!
That's us! Point us at mirages and watch the magic!
If that's the case, then come with me.
So, who are they?
Celeste, these kids are the giants from the hills.
You don't mean from the prophecy.
You think you could fill us in on what's been going on here?
Sure. Where to begin?
So that anchor appeared out of nowhere, then the mirages?
Yeah. The League of S sent me here. I was supposed to just be investigating the anchor.
But by the time he arrived, the vampires were already running amok. I'm told that it was utter chaos.
You didn't see it?
I'm a hired sword, and my job in Tometown is to guard this place, the Library of the Ancients. So rarely do I find myself stepping outside. And it's always quiet here. Nothing seemed amiss, at least not until the town had already been overtaken.
Hey, Celeste, where's...
Oh, he was over there re... How strange. Sid? Are you here? Sid? If you don't answer me, I am going to burn all of these books.
Wait, wait! Those ghastly threats are so unbecoming.
Huh?
Ah, a talking weird thing!
Now what if it's a mirage?
I often wonder the same thing.
How incredibly rude. I am just as human as you. Just because I sometimes have a habit of...
Yes, he does have a habit of going haywire. And it's my job to calm him down.
What? Calm him down? If anything, he looks more broken down than...
I'm back!
Yes, well, it's far harder to break than you'd think. Trust me.
I'll thank you not to refer to
yes,
me
my
as
lord.
An...
May we continue with our conversation now?
Hmm? Oh yes, where were we?
Oh, you're like a book freak. What did you do? Make a body that doesn't sleep just so you could keep reading forever?
Oh, no, please, you have it very wrong. I prefer the term bibliophile, thank you very much.
That's the part that's wrong?
As I understand it, someone just happened to leave that body he's in lying around, and somehow his soul got embedded in it.
His soul's in bed?
Wow! I guess in a way, we are human deep down.
Maybe his soul needs to
I told you I'm human in every conceivable way.
No, you really, really aren't.
And what about you then? You say you're the giants from the hills? Now that right there is the real stretch. I mean, what a hoot!
What a what? Oh! Thomas's not an owl. I mean, it is an easy mistake, but wouldn't you assume she's a skunk or something first?
You! How dare you call me the stinky again? That is the last of straw! I am the fragrant! Roses line up just to get the one whiff of me! What really the stinks is your whole stupid existence!
You don't have to be ashamed of people thinking you're skunky. Skunks are cool, okay?
Time out. Wildlife coolness aside, could you not derail every conversation just because you don't know how to vocabulary?
But rain? Vocabulary's not a verb.
It is if I say so. I'll vocab any way I want to. So can it before I vocab you in the Larry.
I see now you're comedians. Bravo.
Enough. We have more important things to discuss.
Okay, let's get right down to it. Those people back there with the fangs, what is the deal with them?
Wow, right down to business. Huh.
Vampires. They used to be people like us. Until a vampire bite turned them.
Huh?
Now wait. Don't tell me that people can turn into mirages.
And they can't go back to the way they were?
Oh, well, while we're going back, when I was younger and even handsomer, I... I mean, Oh yes, I remember clearly now. According to several books I have read... Those who have become vampires can be cured, provided the vampire that sucked their blood is vanquished before it's too late.
So then, all we have to do is move fast and take out the vampires that did the biting?
That's the basic idea. But of course, those vampires used to be just as human as their victims. So if we're not careful about it, wouldn't we end up sacrificing as many lives as we managed to save in the end? Although, we could always pick off the illiterate vampires first. You're not really living anyway if you've never known the comfort of a good book.
No, I don't think that makes you eligible for slaying. But, point taken, we can't save everyone.
Then, dude, what are we supposed to do?
What if we defeated the first vampire? The one who started the whole thing?
The first?
That's it. If you trace the epidemic back, there has to be a first.
Yes. Let's call that one the Prime. If we defeat the Prime, then the rest.
Hey, yeah! It should cause a ripple effect and fix everyone! We would be vanquishing the Bitey's Biter's Biter!
What do you think? Will it work, Sid?
Well, it hasn't been particularly long since the commotion started, so yes, I believe that it could.
Excellent. What a plan.
Did you follow that, Tama?
What? Of course I did.
Yeah, me too. I was just checking.
All right. So where can we find the Prime?
Let's see. Cloud, when you fight the vampires off, have you noticed any patterns to where they seem to go?
I never gave it much thought, but now that you mention it, they always seem to retreat to the north.
Ah, well, that points to one place.
That's right. The graveyard with all the abandoned Mirage trains. That's their lair.
Then let's not waste any more time. We should go.
Wait, Cloud. Who's going to help the townspeople? I have to stay here.
You wouldn't want me to go bzzzeek and make a big old mess.
Which is exactly the reason why I have to stay here.
So, he's a big pain in the royal the butt and certifiably useless!
Okay, putting aside how completely not funny that is, we can go to the graveyard for you, right?
Huh? Yeah. Vampire schmampire, you just go ahead and point us at any old mirage.
And we'll have to do the rest!
All right then. I guess.
Let's see what the fabled giants can do.
I'll take you to the graveyard. Just say the word. I'll be around.
In case it wasn't obvious, the town is still a big mess. I wish I could help you guys fight, but they need my help. Are you sure you'll be able to face the Prime on your own?
I know we got off on the wrong foot, but I think you've seen by now we can handle ourselves. We got it covered.
Yep. You just worry about the town.
Will do. If things settle down, I'll come find you later. So, next stop, the train graveyard. You ready? Here we are. Welcome to Vampire Land. Also, they don't live here alone. There are other things, too. Be careful.
Wow! Just look at all these choo-choos!
I'm definitely getting that graveyard vibe. It's like a ghost could pop out at any second. That's what I call a lift.
Nothing can surprise us now, huh?
Hey, is that a ghost?
Gotcha. Okay, here we go.
I won't hold back. So bad.
No, thank you.
Know what they call a locomotive with vampire fangs? Yeah, we got this.
I guess we're doing this. Honestly, I'm more impressed he knows the word locomotive.
A choo-choo train. Because it's got fangs. Fangs that chew.
I think I need a pillow to cry in.
There's just no hope for us anymore.
I won't hold back.
Right, let's do this.
Hmm.
graveyard is a really the fascinating... What's the room?
This is a rail yard, not a you-know-what yard, okay? Let's get our terminology straight.
Yes, the ma'am.
Alrighty, let's go.
Come on, bring it.
Opportunity knocks.
Gotcha!
Got this.
It just hit me. Look how far up we are.
Alrighty, let's go.
Come on, bring it.
So really like high altitudes.
Who? Me?
The Prime, dummy. She said bat, not batty. Looks like we've climbed up even higher. Either that, or we've sunk to a new low.
Thank you.
Here we go!
Yeah, we got this.
I think I saw somebody inside of that train.
You were so full of elixirs.
But I saw it too.
But you're really not imagining it?
Holy goblins, you gave me a heart attack!
Oh man, you don't ever change. One little whiff of the supernatural makes you freak out.
Be quiet!
I think we have bigger the things to worry about now!
What the honk is that?
Not again.
The trains are so not getting along lately.
Oh, huh? Speaking of...
What was that?
Do you know the difference between a train and a tram?
Yeah, Rain? This is really not the time!
There's no mistaking that for the anything but a ghost train.
Why couldn't it be a mirage instead of a ghost?
Is one really better than the other?
Yes! Mirages and ghosts are nothing alike!
Oh, good to know.
Rain! Let me take it, Rain!
We have to go after her!
Right!
Just hang on, sis.
Sis!
Rain, you okay?
Huh? Oh yeah, I'm fine.
Okay then. Just checking.
Thank you.
wasn't so bad.
Ideas? Rain?
Chocobo, you feather cut that out.
Good work. Looks like she's gonna pull through now. Her and the town.
Thanks to you. Dude, way to come prepared.
Thanks, Sid. He found out that to defeat the Prime, we'd need a wooden stake from a tree that's been alive longer than him. That took some hunting. I just looked for the oldest tree I could find. Made it just in time.
Good morning, Lon.
Oh, hey. Morning.
Huh? Clouds here?
Huh? Wait! What? I was attacked by the Prime, and then I... Dude, no!
Dude, yes. Seeing you with fangs was creepy. Hey.
Huh?
Hit the hooray! That's 3 out of the 4 keys in the bag!
The Prime must have been holding on to it. Except this key.
What about it?
I don't know. What is it you think these keys are gonna unlock?
Huh? Well, they're keys, so a door, I guess?
Nah. I'm overthinking it. Never mind.
Oh, Cloud! I never thanked you!
Thanks again!
Don't do anything you're gonna regret later on.
Oh, looks like everyone's back to normal now.
Another day has been the saved.
Alrighty then. Next up is... what were we after again?
The Key of Tides.
Will Rain and the Long succeed in their noble adventure? Stay tuned!
And now, back to the adventures of Lon and Rain and Tama and a bunch of mirages and Lon.
Oh, whatever. So, what are we doing? Anybody? Should we go pay one last visit to Celeste and Cid before we head out?
Keys, you say? A temple in the deep? Well, I believe I've heard of such a temple in the Besaide region, directly above us.
So, about this Besaide place...
it sounds like it's the continent that's directly above us!
Good. We won't do any falling to get there.
Be whatever it's called, here we come!
No jokes about B.O. this time? Oh, good.